Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. So once again, we're going to be doing a homework problem that you're probably going to be looking at very soon in microeconomics and macroeconomics if you haven't seen a problem like this already. So it's very, very important to stay on top of this and to keep practicing problems like this where you're asked to find Q and P star so that no matter what the numbers or equations, you're always comfortable and able to solve. With that said, let's get into it. Alright guys, so we have a problem as follows. Suppose we are told that in the market for hockey sticks, demand is given by QD, so quantity demanded, is equal to 100 minus 3P. And supply is given by QS, so quantity supplied, is equal to 2P plus 20. Calculate the optimal price and quantity in this market. Now remember that optimal price and quantity is Q star and P star. This is where the supply and demand curves actually intersect at this point of equilibrium right here. Now you guys already know that, but what we're going to do is take a look at how we can use this and this to calculate that. So let's clean up the frame and we're going to get right into it. All right, so I've isolated the two equations for quantity demanded and quantity supplied, and I've written them out here, as well as drawn a very generic supply and demand graph. Now these aren't, they don't have values on them right now, but obviously we should label our axis. So down here is Q, and this axis is P. That's the same for all supply and demand graphs. And this point right here is the point of intersection. So down here, this would be Q star, and this right here would be P star. And that means that the P and the Q value on these two lines is the exact same. Now, if you look at this, these are just linear equations. This is very, very elementary math for you guys. These are both linear equations. There's no exponents whatsoever. So I'm looking for an intersection where the Qs and the Ps are equal. So the red line is supply, the green line is demand, and I just want to know where Q and P are equal. Well, if at the point of intersection, QD is equal to QS, well then why don't I just set these equations equal to one another and solve? And that's exactly what I'm going to do. So QD is equal to 100 minus 3P, which is equal to QS, and QS is 2P plus 20. So now all I've done is set QD and QS equal to one another. Now you'll notice I have one equation and one unknown. So I can solve for P by rearranging this equation. So I'm gonna move the 3P to this side of the equal sign. I'm gonna move the 20 to this side of the equal sign. And I'm gonna rearrange to get 100 minus 20 equals 2P plus 3p. Now again, you guys know this stuff. When I switch sides of the equal sign, I must switch the sign. So this is positive 20, but on the other side of the equal sign, it's negative 20. This is negative 3p, but on the other side of the equal sign, it's positive 3p. So that's all I did here. Now I know that 100 minus 20 is equal to 80. And I know that 2p plus 3p is equal to 5p. Well, how do I isolate P? I just divide both sides by 5. And upon doing that, I've discovered that P must be equal, P star, I should say, must be equal to 16. So that's one of the values that I want to find. So now I have P star is equal to 16. So I'm going to erase over here. I'm going to erase P star. I'm actually going to write 16 because I know what that value is now. This would be 16 right here. But what about Q star? How do I solve for Q star? Well, if this value, if the P for both of these lines is 16, then I can sub it in to these equations. Now you might be asking yourself, which equation do I sub it into? Do I sub it into QD or QS? Well, they're intersecting, which means that either one that you plug in this 16 into, you can plug it into either one and it's going to give you the exact same Q value. To show you that that's the case, I'll sub it into both and we'll solve for both. And you'll realize that Q star is the same no matter which one you use. So again, on a test scenario, just use one of them. Okay, so I'm gonna make a note for myself that P star is equal to 16. And then I'm going to sub that into both of these. Now again, you don't need to sub it into both. You could sub it into either or, it will give you the same value. So let's sub it in here. I'll sub it into QD first. So I'll say QD is equal to 100 minus 3. And then instead of P, I'm going to sub in the P value, which is 16. Now this is simply equal to 100 minus 48. Therefore, QD is simply equal to 52. Now, I know that this means that Q star is equal to 52. But if you're a little bit skeptical, let's sub it into QS and see if it also equals 52. If it doesn't, then we know we've done something wrong. So let me sub it in here to QS. Is equal to 2 times 16 plus 20. This is simply equal to 32 plus 20. And what do you know? This is also equal to 52. So QS and QD with a price of $16 would both equal 52 for quantity. Therefore, I know that my Q star is 52. And just like that, we've solved for both Q star and P star, which is a point 52, 16, where P star is 16 and Q star is equal to 52. And that is how you solve a problem of this nature. Again, just to recap what we've done, the first thing you want to do is set your quantity demanded equal to your quantity supplied. That's going to get rid of your Qs. Now all of a sudden you have one equation with one unknown. So step number two is going to be to solve for P star. And then once you have P star, step number three, sub in to QD or not and or QS. That's going to give you your Q star. And that's it. Those three simple steps will let you solve any question of this nature. Well, we hope that you guys found this video very informative and that you're going to be able to use the knowledge that you've learned here to do your own problems on assignments and tests. If you enjoyed the video, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and comment what sort of economic topics or homework questions you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.